ultrasonic welding is used to join stranded copper wire to printed circuit board.
Right. Now, this is another important point. Right now, if you want to join two metals, say normally mindset is, you need to melt, okay, hold it for some time and make a joint. Now, that is the mindset of all of us. But actually speaking, without melting also, you can make bonding. Interatomic movement. You have two substrate, right? You have two substrate. You vibrate with ultrasonic frequency for thin wires. You can make a joint. Now what happens is there is exchange of molecules at the atomic level, and you can create a joint. Now that is what ultrasonic welding here. It is not required that you should melt and solidify or heat it to a plastic state and solidify. It is not that. For thin wires, right? You can make joints just to vibrate it. Make interaction with the atomic level and you can certainly make a joint. Now that is another important thing. So this one is a ultrasonic welding. So mainly made of...
It's a worthwhile option to soldering because it's faster and doesn't need any interlayer material. During ultrasonic welding, a side-to-side scrubbing action of 2 to 20 microns at 36 kilohertz takes place in the plane of the substrate. It can be used on plugs and wire connections.
So this is a best substitute for soldering. Now that is not very important. This best substitute for soldering because you need not have a interlayer where you need to heat and melt. Now you don't have an interlayer. You got what I said. So this is another important joining technique.
Single point ultrasonic laser bonding is a novel technique where lasers are used to reflow solder. At the same time, an ultrasonic vibration is passed through the component to strip the copper oxide and clean the surfaces. This enables the operator to solder without flux. The laser does the melting, the ultrasonic vibration does the cleaning.
Actually, two processes here. This is laser. Two things they have called. One is flux is not used. You should understand the importance of flux. The electrode, normally in an arc welding process, the electrode, you have an electrode, now surrounding which you have a, what is that? What is the purpose of flux? What is the purpose of flux? Say, what? What is the purpose of flux? Why do you have flux? You can use a bare electrode without flux, you can weld. You can weld. The purpose of flux, you should understand that when you heat the metal to any high or elevated temperature, atmospheric oxygen will react to the molten metal to form metallic oxides. Now what are metal used? If you heat it to elevated temperature, atmospheric oxygen will react to the molten metal to form metallic oxides. Let it form. What makes you to bother for it? Let it form. The issue here is, if metal is converted to metallic oxide, the weld is going to be a weaker joint. You got the point here. The weld is going to be a weaker joint. So now what you are going to do? So during molten metal. So molten metal is highly prone to react with the atmospheric oxygen during the arc welding process. So now what you are going to do? You have a flux which is coated in the electrode. Now during melting, what happens? The flux also goes along with the molten metal. So in the weld bead, the molten pool of weld bead, this flux mixes with the molten weld pool of metal, right? And because of density difference, because that's very lighter, it comes to the top surface of the molten metal and it covers the molten metal or shields the molten metal from atmospheric oxygen. So that is the purpose of flux. So if it shields, say now after solidification, what you do? You use a scrap to remove the flux. Because the metal is solidified, no problem for us now. You remove the scrap, now that is what you do, you remove the flux. But in this particular process, what it says, you have without flux they are doing. Now that is the main key here. Because when you go for micro joining process, and that too you want to remove the flux later, it is not possible. Because you are going to see the welding only in the microscope. You got the point. And you want to see the, with the microscope and remove the flux, not possible. It is highly tedious process. So the process is prepared in such a way that no flux, joint also should be strong, oxide should not form. Now see, that is the process here. Now this one is a laser welding.
By using a carbon dioxide laser to trim this bonnet pressing, manufacturing time is reduced considerably and tooling changes are eliminated.
Actually speaking, this is not welding. We use laser for cutting the process, but the same thing is used for welding also. That also I will show you. I have some videos on it.
Here we see laser package sealing using a neodymium YAG laser to weld the edge of a gold-plated Kovar package to form a hermetic joint. Kovar is used because it has a similar thermal expansion coefficient to that of the internal alumina substrate.
You can see laser spot welding as well.
See the laser spot welding is increasingly being used on small.
See the dimensions of it, that is what really
important. Here we see a ribbon connector being attached to a battery cell. The ribbon is made of nickel and the cell body stainless steel. The advantage of such a process is that it imparts a very low, highly confined heat input and low mechanical stress. It is in effect a stake weld. Intimacy of contact between the ribbon and the battery is vital for the success of the weld.
So, it's a, why you say again a micro weld? Because it is a small battery. Right now, we are going to weld with the ribbon. Right, for any electronic purposes. Now, just imagine how small it is. And they have made four spot welding. Though it looks big right now, it is very small. It's a small battery. A small battery, they are welding it with the ribbon. Now, it's again, you can see. In the micro welding process. It's a micro welding process. Now, the most important thing is here there is something called heat affected zone. Now, yes, in the welding, if you talk, there is something called heat affected zone. I have two plates. I'm going to weld. Now, when I weld, what happens is the parent metal is also damaged to a certain extent. What is called as heat affected zone? Because the microstructure. Mechanical properties, everything is changed in the heat affected zone. You cannot retain the properties of the parent metal. Here, the most advantage here is heat affected zone is very less. Heat affected zone is very less. See, you go for arc welding process. My steel is there. You are welding. When you weld, what happens? Apart from the bead which is formed, the parent metal to a certain extent because of the heat, there are changes in the metallurgical properties. Once metallurgical properties change, there is change in mechanical properties as well. What is that? You are not getting the required strength. Why? Because you should make sure that the heat affected zone is minimal. Heat affected zone is minimal. Now that is one very important. In this one, though enormous amount of heat is generated, the heat affected zone is almost negligible. Now you just imagine if you have a small battery and if you pass laser, the whole battery will be damaged. You got what I said? So laser, the most advanced technique, laser welding, where you can reduce the thermal effects. Now that is what very important. Now this one, as you all know, we are computerizing almost all the process. Now how robots is useful for welding? Now that is the next thing. See, I have been